Marcello and John, and welcome to Bulgaria. We are right now in sunny town Sandanski, and today we are going to walk around traditional market. So it is actually Easter time, which is going to be tomorrow. We have Easter this year, a week after the you had Easter in wherever country you are in, USA or somewhere in Europe. To be honest, I was a little bit surprised that Bulgarian Easter is the same as the Russian, because they do celebrate Christmas at the same time as European countries and America Catholics, right? So I have no idea why Bulgarian Easter is in the same time as the Russian Easter. But you will see this video a little bit later this week on Thursday, quite as usual my time when I'm posting these videos. Let's go and see what they are going to sell on the market, and I hope you have a nice weather, because we have really lovely weather here. It's like nearly 80 Fahrenheit, so about 26-30 centigrade in Celsius. It's very hot and very pleasant. So if you don't, then I'm sending you a nice weather and sun to wherever you are, guys. Okay, let's go and have a look, check it out. Okay, guys, we just had an announcement that the market of traditional Bulgarian things opened, and it's opening with this beautiful little girls dancing. Bulgarian outfits, as you can see, it's all like all done this beautiful stitching. I actually could do it also. I've learned how to do it. We call it a cross stitching. I don't remember how to say it in English, to be honest. So look, this something like this is 65 lev, and this like for children clothes. So 65 lev divided by 2 and you would know what's in euros, so divided by 169 something you would know what is in dollars. So it's roughly about 30 something dollars, maybe $40, something like that. But that's the traditional. As you can see, they have things in here. Okay, on this side we do have some, I believe, traditional jewelry, so which is also, I'm not sure if it's silver or not. I think it's not. Like, this one is quite cheap. It's only like 5 lev, something like this, and it's only like two and a half euros, you know, about $3 or something. So that's quite it's like, I believe it's a bit quite traditional also. So you put it on your clothes, of course. So let's see the other things. You can have like lots of rings. Lev for this, so it's about $5. I don't know, maybe it's a kind of metal, maybe the one which doesn't get bad. So here we have some liver, but the on the other side is honey and wine. So the wine is 12 lev, 10 lev a bottle, so about $5 roughly. And honey is around 10 lev also, about $5 also for a jar. So as you can see, like I'm saying, it's preparing for Easter. There are some Easter decorations you can get in here. I believe this probably every year, this market. I'm the first time here this time, and it's quite a nice market actually, because I was looking for some things for Easter and I didn't find anything. I was thinking, is it going to be or not? And here we go. So these are like candle Easter eggs, which are like quite pretty. So the cheapest one is like 5 lev, only 2.5. And the bigger one is about 12 lev, 6 euros. So they do have like toys, okay. Handmade, obviously knitting. Oh, here we go. See, thank you for writing it in English, because I'm forgetting my words, you know. I'm speaking Russian, Bulgarian, English, Spanish. It's all mixed in my head, so I'm missing the words, guys. So you see, it's more traditional clothes again, and more. Look how beautiful it is with all these decorations for Easter. If you do like decorate your house for Easter, this is very, very pretty. Okay. So, very nice. Okay, here's some art. Pretty also, isn't it? Some more stuff. These are like traditional toys. So, well, you can, you know, now you know, if you come here for Easter, you can find some interesting things in here. Oh, see, it was on the other side also, some things. So, oh, this must be a wool. I don't know if it's a real wool or probably it is. Quite like funny ones. You can have magnets. Magnets. So this one's looks like from the festival they're doing. Looking souvenir, one of the festivals which I missed last time, unfortunately. And oh, that's the candles you see. I have lots of them. I've seen the first ones like this in Florida. So this, the big one is 24 lev, and the small one 14 lev, 10 lev. So they're quite cool ones. So it's like about 7 euros. So here we have some I guess it's organic and herbs things. So what else we do have? Some more souvenirs, and more souvenirs for Easter, and some souvenirs made of real wood. Okay, and some more jewelry. Okay, and amulets, and also some more here too. Okay, so. There is some funny looking things in there. I don't know what is this, what's it made of, but that looks like 5 lev. That looks like something like quite interesting. I don't know what is that. Okay, guys, so that's I just walked you through the traditional Bulgarian market. It's finished here, and we do have park over there. See how many people. Everybody's enjoying. I mean, some people still wearing warm clothes, but I'm telling you, it's very hot. Believe me, if I'm telling you it's hot, it's hot, because you know me, I'm always cold. So yeah, that's pretty much it, guys. So, and I showed you the park before, and a little bit showing you different things, traditional things will be in Bulgaria for a while again in this trip, and I'll try to show you some more stuff. More maybe villages we will go and see, Bulgarian villages, the life in there, what they look like, and obviously some other things. We'll go to some cafes. I'll show you the prices, what food you can get for what money. I have a lot of people asking how much is the beer in Bulgaria, so you will see it all in my next video. So that's all, guys. If you like it, don't forget to subscribe, like, and I see you next time. Bye everyone.
Ich mag die Kopfhörer,
dass sie so gut sind.